Margaret Bourke White, who at that time is the most famous photographer in the world, is photographing for Life magazine. She comes to India. Because of Jana's reputation, she hears about him, so she comes to the party office in Bombay and comes to P.C. Joshi and asks him that, you know, can I meet Sunil Jana and can I get his assistance for the work that I'm doing for Life magazine. So Joshi brings Bourke White into the room and introduces Jana to her. And they immediately become very close friends. And as Jana writes, he's 26 years old then, and she's 36 years old. And, you know, with that much more experience around the world, she has photographed the Dust Bowl and effectively the famine in the US in the 1930s, early 30s already. She has photographed the war in Europe and in a very frontline position, going in with troops and photographing, you know, terrible horrors, which are astounding to see now because you don't see war photography like that any longer. So when she comes in 1945 to Bombay, she takes, 44 or 45, she takes Jana with her on Life magazine money. She can hire a car, you know, she can provide food. He and some comrades are going on party work into Rayalaseema and Andhra, areas of Tamil Nadu, because there's a terrible famine happening there, which again is not documented and not known by the rest of India. So they travel together on her money and her expense. And she's basically, she says, you know, I'll just pay and you do what you're doing. So she effectively travel, you know, joins their caravan into those areas of Andhra, and she said, okay, I'll do a story on the famine as you are doing, but I'll do it for Life magazine. So they work together very closely for a long time, and it's his writing on that period is very interesting because she's, as he says, he realized that the way she worked and made pictures was actually quite similar to his, but she was a much more advanced version of himself, both technically and with experience. And of course, there was a big difference because she has, you know, resources that the party just couldn't mobilize. So she was not worried about how much film she was using, how many flash bulbs she was using. In any case, Jana didn't have flash. So there's a fantastic episode when they travel through Andhra where he actually uses her flash. I mean, she's actually making her picture with her flash gun connected to her camera. But he makes his picture by just keeping his shutter open at the same time that she fires her flash. So it's her flash that exposes his film in the interiors of these huts, photographing the peasants who are starving. So this is an almost unheard of collaboration between photographers. And I've never, you know, seen an episode like this in any other photographer's body of work. And both become very, I mean, she's already a famous photographer, he's famous in India. So it's a remarkable collaboration between these two photographers of a very unusual nature.